In this video, we are going to show you how to use the SpectroVis Plus coupled with the LabQuest 2 to determine the concentration of an unknown sample by UV-vis spectroscopy. You'll have your unknown solutions, multiple capped sample vials, a 25 mL volumetric flask, a burette, up to 3 cuvettes, and some Kim wipes. The common glassware is also available. Cuvettes may look like this. Some have a clear side versus an opaque side. These cuvettes must be placed into the SpectroVis so that the clear side faces the light source. Some cuvettes have a Y shape. These cuvettes must be placed into the SpectroVis so that the Y shape faces the light source. To calibrate the instrument, insert a blank, which is a clean cuvette filled with deionized water. Tap sensors, then calibrate. Calibrate the spectrophotometer. Tap OK, and if the SpectroVis has already been in use, you may skip the warm-up. Once warm-up is completed, click Finish Calibration. If we choose the darkest sample, you'll see that the sample is giving an absorbance of 1.021 at 629 nanometers. This absorbance is outside of the linear range. The instrument chose 629 nanometers as the wavelength of maximal absorption. It is here that we see a minimal change in absorbance per unit change in wavelength. Thus, when we monitor absorbance as a function of concentration, we see a linear relationship. Let's check the absorbance of a much more dilute sample. Always wipe the sides of the cuvette with a Kim wipe to remove fingerprints and other interferences. Push the green arrow, then the red square, to obtain a reading. The meter in the top left-hand corner displays the absorbance. An absorbance of 0.185 is below ideal for this experiment. Let's try one more sample. This one is a Y-shaped cuvette. Remember to wipe all sides and place the cuvette into the SpectroVis so that the Y-shaped side is pointed toward the light source. Push play, then stop, and you'll see that the absorbance at lambda max is 0.598. This is a value we can use in our calibration curve. Your calibration curve will be a plot of absorbance versus concentration. Check for linearity and use linear regression to solve for the concentration of your unknown. Remember that you just determined the concentration of the sample in your cuvette, not the original unknown sample we used to prepare this dilution. You'll have to back calculate. One more bit of advice: it is usually worthwhile to take data in triplicate. That's it! Good luck with the determination of the concentration of your unknown S, and we'll see you in lab!